Of the countless obscure and strange kanji in Japanese, there are a select few characters that shouldn't even exist. And aside from being trapped in computers around the world, they really don't. Most of them were pulled into existence by accident, never intended to appear in these forms. These kanji are referred to as yuureimoji, or ghost kanji. With no real meaning or reading, it is definitely a weird thing to see pop up on a computer, especially in the 80s. And this is where the term ghost kanji comes from. They are apparitions that appear on computers, never meant to exist. In all seriousness, the characters obviously aren't really spirits that just pop into existence, so they had to come from somewhere. All the way back in the 70s, there was a clear need to have a good way to write Japanese on a computer. You don't want to get left behind in the coming digital age, after all. In around 7 years, they were able to compile a list of nearly 7,000 characters that would be the base of the digital kanji. This would become the JIS encoding, standing for Japanese Industrial Standard, established in 1978. I'll get into the encoding aspect more later, but just to sum it up really quickly, having these kanji encoded in a standardized manner was a really good base start for digital communications in Japan. However, not all of them were very useful, and this was quickly discovered after the encoding was already finished. And according to the professionals, once a character is encoded, it's a character whether people like it or not. Which makes sense because you don't really want to just erase characters from existence, because that would create a lot more problems than just leaving them in. If they were removed, you would just be left with blank spaces, and if they were replaced, other kanji would just take their spot, which would obviously conflict with what individuals used for their websites and computers. Not to mention the fact that all the computers that already used the old version wouldn't just magically have the new version the next day. There's a lot of reasons for it, and this is not a video really focused on character encoding, so I'm just gonna leave that out. Unfortunately, around a year after JIS was established, 61 characters were found to be ghosts, holding no meaning or reading, basically an empty shell of what could be a kanji. After some time, this number went up and down, new ghost kanjis were found, and others were proven to be real, meaning they were used and did have readings and meanings. They were just really uncommon. These findings were in large part due to an investigation in 1997, where a lot of effort was put into finding the origins of these characters. A lot of that effort was due to poor source listing from the original creators of JIS. Instead of writing something like National Administrative Districts, Volume 2, page 107, they just wrote something like National Administrative Districts as their source. And when there's 7 volumes of that and hundreds of pages in each one, it makes it really hard. And while yes, it technically is a source, it's not one I would really want to rely on. Investigations found that many of the kanji were actually just being used in place names. So although they might have been unique or rare, they certainly weren't just made out of thin air. Though if every kanji was just an uncommon place name, I obviously wouldn't be making this video. After much effort and researching through ancient writings and various other old and modern books, the number of yuureimoji was left at just 12 characters. Some of the ghost kanji were found to be typos, and for good reason. Not only did those unidentified characters have very similar looking counterparts, but those similar looking characters were actually real. And they were, coincidentally, not in the character bank, which paints a pretty clear picture of a typo in my mind. The wrong character was just made, and the creator just kept moving, due to not realizing the mistake. Good to know that even in the 70s, people were making mistakes on computers. Not all typos are equal though, and I actually think one is objectively a lot cooler. There's only like 3 typos that are actually high likelihood, so here they are. This kanji, which is very similar to ten, ken is very similar to kude, and the best one is shi. It is very similar to this, which actually isn't very normal itself. The mistake here was supposedly made when trying to photocopy this kanji. However, during the process, a mistake was made, and this line was added. Apparently, they used printed sheets or paper, something of that sort, in order to create the character. And when the mock-up was photocopied, the line between the paper became part of the kanji. I saw this post of a tattoo the other day where people hypothesized that the tattoo artist accidentally left the cursor in their design, which seems very similar and I think adds some backing to the photocopying theory here, if the other one on Reddit is real. That being said, where does the base character come from? I did see in a Chinese dictionary, if this is correct, that it is used in Taiwanese names, which I could neither confirm nor deny. I would assume it wouldn't be added to JIS just because of that though. What I can confirm though, due to previous investigations of X users, is that this character does appear in the real world. It not only can be seen at the bottom of this sign with the reading of Akenbara, but nearby there is a sign with presumably the original form, Akebihara. When you stack the two characters, you get the ghost character, or something close to it at least, without the mistake. This is a really interesting situation to me, because as I said before, this one's not so normal itself. and I wonder if the creator was even trying to put this character in the first place. Aside from the typos, there is also one of the more famous ghosts. Unfortunately, I took 1 year of Chinese in high school, and every time I look at this, I just hear giga. And somehow I never learned how to pronounce it correctly, so that's kind of unfortunate. Anyways, as I said, this one is neither a typo nor an obscure place that turned out to actually exist. This is the one true ghost character that there really isn't a great answer. Although there aren't any great answers in terms of actually getting a definitive origin, there certainly are some that are fun speculations. My favorite, and one that is well supported, is that the character appeared in this old article from 1923. Saying it like that, it really doesn't sound that interesting. However, what is interesting is that the character, even in the article, is kind of a mystery. It seemed to be thought of as a typo which not only appeared in the actual article, but also made its way into the labeling of it, which is how it was even found in the first place. On top of that, even in the 70s when the encoding was being created, this article would have been 50 years old. I kind of like to imagine the creators of JIS found the kanji with stacks of old newspapers to get characters from it, but I imagine that isn't really what happened. It was discovered, however, that the ghost character appearing in that article was incorrect. This was the correct character to be used, and can be seen correctly printed and labeled in another scan. There was likely an error somewhere in the printing process or copying process that led to it looking like this. This doesn't tell us if the JIS character was actually made from that character mistake, though. And unfortunately, that's why I said it's considered the most mysterious. Due to this unsolved mystery, though, the character conveys basically just that. A mysterious, scary character that should not exist. Using games, analog horror, and music, it's a really cool way to turn an otherwise meaningless character that wasn't even supposed to be there into something fun. Or also really scary. Even though the vagueness of this character did help in making it popular to use in this way, some of the other ghost kanji have actually been used in their own media. And many have actually been given readings and meanings. Such as 5A73, a mystery book where this character is written on the bodies of murdered victims. At first, I thought this was the Unicode to the character, however, it ends up going to this one. Maybe that's part of the mystery though, I'm not really sure. If you've read the book, please tell me. The kanji that I don't mention are kind of less interesting. They are both typos and uncommon kanji. How I said the typos are clearly typos because the original isn't in the character bank. These characters, the presumed original, are in the character bank, along with the mistake, leaving two characters that look very similar, though one is an imposter. Aftermath. Aftermath sounds like it's kind of blown out of proportion. It kind of is. However, I noticed some of these weird and pretty annoying things when researching. Some of the original characters that the ghost characters are likely based on are not in Unicode. In Unicode, there is a section of CJK Unified Ideographs, standing for Chinese, Japanese, and Korean encoding of ideographs, which is widespread now. CJK basically combined the repetitive characters. If a character appeared in both Chinese and Japanese, the character would just be a single character in CJK. You might even say unified. And there's also some other languages to CJK, but it's kind of confusing. I don't really know. Due to this unification, space is saved and Unicode is a lot better for it. However, Unicode, which houses CJK, is not the only encoding method. For example, the JIS that we talked about earlier is its own encoding method, along with its character banks. It's kind of confusing and I don't really know how to describe it. I'm not a computer scientist. And some of the characters are not included in CJK, which leaves some really annoying and incongruent behavior in text. Even though it's pretty much the standard now, a lot of sites and software still just rely on old encoding banks and methods. And these incongruencies can even lead to things like mojibake, where text fails to be displayed or the app you're on suddenly becomes an ARG. Kind of relating to these ghost kanji, while researching I found this book, and I thought it was really cool and kind of fit the theme of this video. It's a book made up of 4,000 Chinese characters, which doesn't really sound that weird itself, until you realize that all of the characters are actually fake. Similar to ghost characters, these are meaningless and readingless. However, unlike the ghost characters, these were made on purpose by the artist Xu Bing. Xu Bing. I did a whole year of Chinese in school just to not be able to pronounce anything. It's very sad. First, he created the 4,000 characters, then carved them into wood blocks and pressed them onto paper. It doesn't really sound like a lot, only being 3 steps, but when you think about it, 4,000 characters being carved into wood blocks and then stamped is a lot of work. Anyways, that's it for the main part of the video. I do want to quickly say that I am not an AI. I am, in fact, a real person. I have had multiple people say that I do not blink. This is actually a scary fact, as when I looked over some of the videos where people said that, I, in fact, do not blink. But then I got this comment on the last video. Great content, but I'm pretty sure I wasn't the only one who felt uncomfortable looking at a fake person talking. So I just wanted to state the fact that I am a real person and I have no plans to upload myself into the metaverse. Let that be known. Also, saving the best for last, thank you to everyone who commented under this comment on the last video. I didn't expect anyone to actually reply to it, and you guys gave very helpful advice, so I do greatly appreciate that. Anyways, thanks for watching again, and sorry for talking so much. I do apologize. Anyways, thank you. Bye-bye.